Dear students, we are in BBA, fourth semester, subject of startup management. Before I start the class, let me ask you one question. Startup, what do you mean by startup? Can anybody say? What is a startup? Yes, can you hear me? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
What is a startup? Startup means
early stage.
Okay, very good. Startup means setting up a
new idea, sir.
Starting a business organization with a new idea, with an idea. Okay, what is management? Management implies making others work towards a goal, towards organizational goal. If he is a good manager, means all will work very efficiently and effectively for the benefit of the organization. That is what you mean by saying management, startup management. In startup management, some important topics related to BBA fourth semester we will learn. This is a 2-credit course. Okay, so I will start with the topic of characteristics of an entrepreneur. Who is an entrepreneur? Who is an entrepreneur? Yes, very good. Entrepreneur is a person who starts a business organization. Enterprise. He starts an enterprise, means a business organization. He will start, he will take all the steps to establish a business organization. Okay, so I will start with the subject of characteristics of an entrepreneur. Who is an entrepreneur? Okay, what are the characteristics of him? I will check and I will let you know. This is a web source already. From that web source, I am explaining to you. That's all simply. These are the characteristic features of an entrepreneur. Creativity will be there. What is creativity? Are you able to see this? Is it visible?
No, sir.
Okay. Are you able to see?
No, sir.
No? Okay. Now, are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
This is JBCN International School website I am using. So these are the 10 characteristic features of an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur, as mentioned by me, as mentioned by your friends, is a person who establishes an organization. These are the characteristic features of an entrepreneur, successful entrepreneur or entrepreneur. Creativity. What is creativity? In the word itself, it is there, creating something new. It may be new idea. It may be new product. It may be new thinking. That is what you mean by saying creativity. Originality will be there. Novelty will be there. So newness will be there. Newness of ideas, thoughts. That is what you mean by saying creativity. Entrepreneur will be creative. Entrepreneur will be professional. Professional means with pakka planning, with efficient and effective planning. Entrepreneur will establish an organization. How many resources are required? Well, it may be monetary resources, non-monetary resources. How much money is required? He will plan properly. Raw materials from where to procure. Everything will be planned properly by the entrepreneur. Risk taking will be there. It means entrepreneur will take risk. What do you mean by risk? Risk refers to possibility of happening, of occurring of loss, suffering a loss. So entrepreneur will take the risk of suffering a loss. He will take various steps to minimize loss, but he will have courage. He will take that risk. He will have passion. What do you mean by passion? You have a passion to become a good entrepreneur. Let us take for example. What do you mean by passion? Passion means strong desire. Okay, to achieve something. So So entrepreneur will be having a passion to achieve something. And every entrepreneur will have pakka planning. What do you mean by planning? Perfect planning will be there for an entrepreneur. What is planning? There is a quotation in English. If you are failing to plan, you are planning to fail. I repeat, if you are failing to plan, you are planning to fail. That is the importance of planning. What is planning? Yes, what is planning?
For future, we are taking steps, sir.
Okay, planning means thinking in advance. About, as told by Aditya, about future, it may be about future career, it may be future personal life, it may be about future prospects regarding life or regarding career. So something regarding future, you are going to make a kind of a systematic arrangement, systematic thinking about future. That is what you mean by saying a plan. So entrepreneur will have planning. Without planning, he cannot establish an organization. Entrepreneur will have knowledge. Knowledge means, what is knowledge? Yes, what is knowledge? You have a good knowledge of commerce. You have a good knowledge of statistics. You have a good knowledge of economics. If I told, what do you mean by knowledge? In simple terms, knowledge means knowing. You know about it. So the entrepreneur will be knowing about certain things. It may be monetary things, non-monetary things, planning, or various resources from where he can get procure the resources. Everything will have a proper knowledge, understanding. Social skills will be there for an entrepreneur. What do you mean by social skills? It may be talkativeness. It may be cheerfulness. It may be language skills that are required. It may be sympathy. It may be empathy. So all these skills will be possessed by an entrepreneur. Open-mindedness will be there. Means he will be lovable towards people or learning. Or even he likes sometimes failure also, because he has the courage to take the failure also. So open-mindedness, he will not be shy regarding failures. Empathy will be there. What do you mean by empathy? Empathy means exactly, suppose if any person is late for an examination because of heavy rains or because of some road blockage, because of some election rally, he became late to the examination. Actually, 9 o'clock examination will start. Up to 9:15 we can allow. It is a 1 hour examination. It will end at 10, but he came at exactly 9:55. Strictly according to rules, we cannot allow him. But if I am the invigilator, I think from the point of view of the student, why he was late, I will inquire. And if it is reasonable, means I will accept that, I will allow that student to come into the class, to the examination hall. So that is how I behaved, means with empathy I behaved. Means I think from the position of the others in order to understand them. So entrepreneur will have empathy. So entrepreneur will have the feeling of the customer is everything. Customer is the king, consumer is the king, we say. So the entrepreneur will always feel that customer is the king. These are the characteristic features of entrepreneur. You can see creativity, professionalism, risk taking, passion, planning, knowledge, okay, social skills. It may be relationship building, hiring and talent sourcing, team strategy formulation, open-mindedness. You see, these are the 10 characteristic features of entrepreneur. Yes, did you understand? That we discussed is characteristics of an entrepreneur. Second topic that we are going to discuss is entrepreneurs will versus managers. What is the difference between entrepreneur and a manager? This topic we will discuss. Topic I have taken from topper.com. See, the main difference between entrepreneur and manager is, entrepreneur is the owner of the organization, whereas manager is the employee. Okay, an entrepreneur is the owner of the company, whereas a manager is the employee of the company. Entrepreneur is a risk taker. If crores of rupees come as profit, he will enjoy that profit. If organization is utter flop, there are losses to the organization, he will bear the risk. So he is a risk taker. He takes risk. Entrepreneur has a vision and focuses on achievements and profit. Whereas managers, they do not take risk. For them, regularly salary will be paid. Even if crores of rupees are earned as profit, or if the organization incurred losses, managers will be paid salaries. Okay, irrespective of the profit or losses, the organization has to pay salary to the manager. Whereas entrepreneur will bear the risk. Okay, so coming to the differences between entrepreneurs and manager, this is important. Entrepreneur is visionary and bears all financial risks. The manager works for salary only. As mentioned by me in the beginning of this topic, manager is an employee. He is the owner. Entrepreneur is the owner. So manager works for salary and does not have to bear any risks. Manager will not bear any risks. For him, salary is fixed. Whether profit is there or loss is there, the salary is fixed for a manager. Whereas entrepreneur, he will be acting as a visionary. He will have plans. He will take risk. Okay. He will focus on starting a business and expanding the business. Whereas his focus will be on the daily smooth functioning of business. He is a normal employee, manager is. So normally how the organization is functioning, smooth, for the smooth functioning of the organization, what are the steps that need to be taken will be taken care of by the manager. Okay. So for entrepreneur, main motivating factor is the achievement of the organization. Running it successfully is the motivating factor for the entrepreneur. So for entrepreneur, motivation, these achievement of the organization. Okay, for manager, what motivates a manager is his power in the organization. Power comes with position, please remember. So he is a higher level manager, whereas he is a lower level manager. Let us take for example. So he will be motivated by his position more than this person, because he is at lower level, whereas he is at higher level. So for manager, what motivates him is his power. From where that power came with that position. So for manager, motivating factor is power with position. For an entrepreneur, it is organization's achievement that motivates him. Okay. For entrepreneur, what is the reward that he gets? He gets profit. That is his reward. Whereas for manager, what is the reward? Remuneration as the salary. He will receive salary, whereas the entrepreneur will receive profits. Okay. Entrepreneur can be informal and casual because organization is his only. So he can behave as he wishes. Whereas manager's approach to every problem is formal. Officially only he can behave, because he is a normal employee in the organization. Whereas entrepreneur is the owner, he can behave as he wish. Okay. If casually he can behave, informally he can behave, or formally also he can behave, because he is the original owner of the organization. Manager can behave only formally. He is only an employee in the organization. So these are the differences between entrepreneur and manager. Okay, did you understand? Or are there any doubts? In the examination, if it is asked, means this table, you have to, first of all, you have to define entrepreneur and manager. This is the different, this is the meaning, definition of the entrepreneur and definition of the manager. Okay. And you have to, after defining these two terms, you have to draw this table, that is entrepreneur versus manager, and these sentences you have to write. I hope you understood. Third topic. Third topic that I am going to discuss in this subject is importance of small scale industries. What is a small scale industry? Are you able to see the screen? Are you able to
see? Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. What is the meaning of small scale industry? Can anybody define? Small scale industry is also known as SSI. In an abbreviated form, we will call it as SSI. Small scale industry. What is a small scale industry? With very less investment, with very less capital, with very less number of employees, if an industry is set up, that is a small scale industry. But according to the definition given by the Industries Development and Regulations Act 1951, a small scale enterprise is one enterprise in which investment in plant and machinery ranges between 25 lakhs to 5 crores. Did you understand? If it is a production industry, means small scale industry implies the capital investment in plant and machinery should be between 25 lakhs and 5 crores. Whereas if it is engaged in services sector, means it may be hospital, it may be any trust. In such a case, the investment should be between 10 lakhs and 2 crores. In such a case, that will be termed as small scale industry. If it is engaged in a production sector, the investment in a plant and machinery should be between 25 lakhs and 5 crores. If it is in a service sector like hospital, the investment requirement should be between 10 lakhs and 2 crores. That is what you mean by saying small scale industry in our country. You have to define this small scale industry. If at all this is given in the examination, in your notes, we have to define first of all what is small scale industry. Okay. So what is the importance of small scale industry? This is the importance. Now you can see it will increase production in the country. Okay. Always with huge investments, people will not be able to produce. Small scale industries are required in the country to increase the production in the country. Increase exports. If production is more, automatically country can be able to export more. So in order to increase exports, SSIs, small scale industries are required. Improves the employment rate. See, in our country, one of the major problem is unemployment problem. So in order to reduce unemployment problem, small scale industries are required. They help in improving employment rate. Okay. New opportunities will be opened with the help of small scale industries. Several job opportunities or several natural resources are there in the country. But in order to tap those natural resources, only big industries are not enough. Similarly, big industries, if you establish more, environmental problems will be there, ecological problems will be there, sociological problems will be there, psychological problems will be there. Economical problems will be there. If you encourage small scale industries, many opportunities will be opened in this society. Advances welfare. So all people cannot establish big industries. Only small investments are available in the country with large sections of people. They can establish small scale industries very easily compared to large scale industries. So it will increase welfare among the people of the country. So these are the advantages, and this is the importance of small scale industry. So those points are explained under side headings also. If at all this is given in the examination, we have to write this point wise. First of all, you have to define small scale industries as defined by me like this. And again, you have to write this side heading. First, these points you should write, and again, those points again you have to put as side heading, and at least write 2 sentences under each side heading. That will be enough.